y'all know that's and hear the story directly from Mau Mau. Then get down to some business about just Ryan is a producer that I've been working with for the last 2 years. That was brought to me by Ed Woods, who did Ryan assign to their label, and also as a producer and has done some stuff for the label. And somebody's like one of my go-to people. New act and just need a record right away. It's somebody that can go in the trenches, musical genius, you know, new age Teddy Riley, Dr. Dre, Quincy Jones, Pharrell, but to his level, in his own way. But he had something else that was very important that attracted me to his situation, which was he had a new global outlook. He had a record that he didn't put out here, and he went and started going over to Europe and doing shows and starting to build a following over in Europe. And I took notice to that because I didn't really see a lot of artists that would have the ingenuity to do that. So when he was doing that, I heard he also had a young lady that was with him named Cassie that had a record out. And I started hearing this record that was haunting me in the clubs. And it was, you know, it was Cassie's record, Me and You. And I would hear it everywhere I was at. And so I kept asking, what record is that? And Gwen told me that it was Ryan's act, it was Cassie. When I saw her and I met her and I saw this DVD on her, hopefully we can play that. That's what kind of made me like really fall in love with the project, because I saw something more than just records. I saw something that there was a personality there. There was something that, you know, the whole world could fall in love. Everybody in me.
Is there anything that you may want to confess tonight before you go in?
I keep everything. Right here.
There you go. That's how you do it, right? Yeah. Y'all have an amazing final question. Is there?
Listen, Bassist Loaded, bottom of the ninth. I want to talk about this Sean Combs situation. No more nicknames, let it breathe. Because look how he's talking about Cassie right now at the table in 4K. He's caught in 4K. Like, he is smiling from ear to ear. He's excited. So I just want all men to understand that, to me, this is lust. And this is why it's important as a man to control your lust. Because, see, when you have lust for a woman, you really don't like her. So when you smiling from ear to ear, it's the lust that's smiling. And it's really not true. Let me tell you guys something. You could tell in the beginning he actually, you know, had real, genuine feelings. And I feel like it's so important that all men, we must remove our ego. Take your ego out of the situation, because if you take your ego out of the situation, you could live your whole life without raising a hand at a woman. Listen, I'm 37 years old. Listen, I have yet to raise my hand at a woman, and I don't plan on it because it's certain principles that I live by. And I feel like you have to know the difference between love and lust. Listen, if you can master this as a man, listen, trust me, you'll be good to go. Now, Sean Combs, in the beginning, it was lust for Cassie. Now, Cassie, I'm not going to lie. When she made the song, Me and You, I'm not even going to lie. Matter of fact, till this day, in the words of Deontae Wilder, till this day, Cassie still looks amazing. So at the end of the day, this is why I told you guys since day one. When I first came to YouTube, I told you guys the whole high-value message was a dark message. And this is what the dark side of capitalism is. Now, the reason I say there's always two sides, because capitalism, it gives people the opportunity to start an LLC, start a business like other countries. It's not that easy. But the dark side of capitalism, it makes you feel that if you have money, you're above the law and you could do things. And not only can you do things, but you could also get away with things. This man literally gave an award speech and he said, shout out to my lawyer that's been keeping me free. That shit tells you something right there. That means that this man has been in a lot of cases. Let me tell you guys something. He was 37 when he met her. She was 19. Now, she was in the wrong place. Definitely. She was trying to, you know, become famous. She was definitely trying to be a singer. So if it wasn't Sean Combs, somebody in the industry, this is just what they do in the industry. Not only that, someone probably did it to Sean Combs as well. But you guys have to understand. At the age of 37, if you were a 19-year-old woman and she is with you, she is looking for you to lead her. You're not going to lead her into a chokehold. You're not going to lead her into a black eye. You know, it's a lot of beautiful women out here in the world. And I just feel that a lot of men, if they're not secure within themselves, they're going to try to do whatever to bring that woman down. Like I said, she was in the wrong industry from the start. When you want to come, when you want to become famous, there's a price for that. And a lot of people, any purity that you have, they will try their hardest, like Sean Combs, to bring that out of you. Now, let's talk about the craziest thing about this. Sean Combs wanted her at 19 while he's 37, and this lasted for a decade too. He wanted her to get, you know, reading between the lines by other men while he watched. No love. No love for this young, no love for this younger woman. At the end of the day, this right here is disgusted, and I really feel like he needs to go to prison. I feel like the prison is where he belongs. Like, he's running around, he's acting like an animal, and when you act like an animal, you need to be put in a cage like an animal. If the female is 19 and you want her to be with other guys in front of you, if she's cool with that, she's, I mean, that's between you and her. But you give her drugs in the beginning. So you get her on the drugs, and then after that you make her make out with other people while you sit back and you watch. Listen, everything in moderation, fellas. A lot of you guys, you look at these guys, these entertainers, you're like, oh, they got so much woman, they got so much woman, they got so much woman. But that's the thing, they got so much woman, they out here just running around releasing all over the world to the point they tired and they drain, and the only thing that excites them is the stuff that you'll see on the hub. Why would you even want, quote unquote, your girlfriend to be with another man in front of you while you watch? This right here, the plot thickens. And multiple times, grape situations, it's like, listen, this man right here let the darker voices prevail in his head. This man right here had an assignment for this younger woman. And I feel like, let these younger women live. If you 37 years old and you date a 19-year-old woman, listen, you got to be a leader and you got to show her nothing but a good time. You got to elevate her. Listen, you got to do some great things. If you're 37 and you're dating a 19-year-old woman, listen, she should be well-rounded just because you're 37. You don't date a 19-year-old at 37 and you come through and you hit her with backhands. Like, this right here should not have been allowed. I don't care if it's the music industry, I don't care. Listen, when it comes to a man, I feel like you got to keep that same energy, the same way you felt about it the first day you saw her, the first day you felt about it when y'all both went out and got ice cream and y'all was eating lasagna and y'all both slurped up the noodles at the same time. Keep that same energy. The minute that feeling is gone, end the relationship, move on. It's going to be better. Nobody's going to get hands put on them. This right here, I feel like this is the last straw for Sean Combs. No more nicknames. No more nicknames. They've been calling him by his nicknames to the point that people have been blinded to the light from the fact that he paid $1 million hit for Tupac. That's one body. Biggie Smalls, his best friend, that's a second body. Humiliated everybody on In the Band. Made him walk and get cheesecakes. At the end of the day, his best friend, Black Rob, who made the hit single Whoa, that he probably still making money off till his day, this man was homeless and couldn't get a dime from Sean Combs. And you mean to tell me that this man has been running around more than two decades terrorizing and screwing up people's life, and people think that just because you have money, you could buy yourself out of situations? Not all the time. And I'm so happy that Cassidy finally gathered the strength, because a lot of people always want to come out and say, well, why so late? Why so late? Listen, unless you've been in that situation, unless you went through that trauma, it takes people time to heal. It takes time for people to build courage. So at the end of the day, as far as the time, I don't think the time is important. My main thing is, did it really happen? Did he really put hands on her? Did he really make her make out with other guys? But first, he gave her substances before he made her do that. Like, you got to understand, this is a sick man right here. And she was at the Met Gala. The guy shook her hand. Look how Sean Combs, no more nicknames. Look how Sean Combs, that's who he is. Look how Sean Combs is looking at her. He's looking at her the same way Ike was looking at Tina Turner. It's the same thing. And Tina Turner, when Tina Turner was young, Tina Turner was beautiful. Let me tell you something to all beautiful women out there. I just want to let you know that God doesn't make mistakes. So even if the world considers you ugly, you're still beautiful. And when you're beautiful, you got to understand, it makes some men insecure. And it's crazy that Sean Combs is supposed to be at the Met Gala. I mean, come on, how long did it take for this man to pick out this suit? How much preparation it probably took for him to leave the dressing room? And you mean to tell me, after all of that, you got the coolest suit on, tailor-made, and all you could do is look at her with disgust while another man shakes her hand? Listen, whatever Sean Combs was going through, he called it on the award show his dark times. Fellas, I have seen this time after time after time after time again. Men are going to do what they want to do. It is what it is. Let it breathe. But if you're going through dark times, why would you want to be next to a woman in dark times? As a man, listen, if you younger guys, rock on my content, put a 100 in the chat. I'm going to tell you something as a young man. If you're going through dark times, you need to be alone, and you need to pray to God, and you need to get out those dark times by yourself. Don't keep women around in your dark times. My man had an award show after he did what he did. I guess his guilty conscience was kicking in. So he said, shout out to Cassie. She was around in my dark times. That's not what you're selling people on the music video. What you're selling people in the music video is wave your rollies in the sky, wave it side to side, and wave your hands high. You're selling people this Bentley Maybach lifestyle, but you're not making music that you're in dark times. You're not telling the people that you're in dark times, but every time you come out on it and the camera's on, you're running around here, Harlem shaking, and you're dancing. This is why I tell you guys, we are witnessing the end of celebrities. When I was growing up, listen, Sean Combs has been on TV since at least I was in middle school. I graduated 2003, and like I said, this man has been on MTV since I was in middle school. And the whole time, he has this image as a businessman, a motivational hustler. He is not a hustler. Everything was handed to him. Ciroc was handed to him. Everything was handed to him. All the artists, everything was handed to him. The royalties was handed to him. And this is why you never want to kiss people ASS, because a lot of people kiss his ASS in the past, and it came to backfire on them. Now, Cassie, she wanted to be famous, and the hit Me and You, None of My Business, I don't know how many records it sold, but there probably was a reason that she probably felt that if I go with this man, I will have some sense of security. And I think that if you're 37 and you're dating a 19-year-old woman, I feel like that's a perfect thought to have. If I'm 19 and you're going to date a man that's 37, yeah, you're going to think that this man is going to treat me right. He's going to take good care of me. This is crazy that this man was 37. I'm 37 years old. I can't imagine being with a 19-year-old and putting hands on a 19-year-old. I just can't imagine that. I can't imagine being at 37, bases loaded, bottom of the ninth, pump up the volume. I can't imagine feeling like that and at 37 chilling with a 19-year-old and say, yeah, let's get some guys in here and yeah, make out with these guys because I'm Sean Combs. What? This is crazy at 19. Listen, to all older men out here, listen, I believe if they're 18, they're legal. If you mess with an 18-year-old, a 19-year-old, and you're not trying to empower them, leave them alone. Because what happened is, instead of Sean Combs trying to empower the female, Sean Combs, he was trying to devour the female. And my main thing is this, as a man, you got to ask yourself, why would you even want to raise hand at a woman that you wanted so bad? I feel like if you want her so bad, what changed? You feel me? Like, the only thing that could change that to me, I feel like, are insecurities. Get rid of all insecurities. Believe in yourself. Believe that you're great. Believe that you're the one. And once you feel that way, I feel that however a woman views you or whatever a woman says, it's not going to trigger you. I feel like for this man to put hands on a 19-year-old female at the age of 37, she probably wasn't kissing his ASS. And that's what some people want. And if you don't do it, they want to put you in a place. Let me tell you something. Cassie is strong, and I'm happy that she's coming out. And I will be covering this case. I will be on it. Listen, we needed Lil Bootsy to go to jail. Somehow, he maneuvered like Houdini. But at the end of the day, I think Sean Combs is going down, and I'm going to continue to cover this. Let it breathe.